Anupriya, in your sector, we do find a good women representation. But how do you think overall in the economy, more and more we talk about, you know, women participation needing to be increased much beyond what there is to power this growth. What do you think needs to be done? Where is it really not happening? What is the story and how do you think we can power that?
I'll just set a context and add to what Ashima said and then I'll come to our industry. So it is true that participation of women in the Indian workforce is extremely low if you compare. We are today the fifth largest economy, hoping to go to third largest. But if we compare ourselves to any of the top economies, be it US, UK, Japan, China, Germany, the fact of the matter is that we are way behind in terms of women participation, and she mentioned it was 22%. One of the things that, one of the positive developments which has happened in recent times is that the total fertility rate has come down. So it stands at about 2.1 now. Some decades back it was like an average woman would have like 6+ children, or at least so the statistics said. Now that's a very good indicator that possibly, and also the ratio of dependence has come down. So that's a great place that we are in at this point, and there's a lot of potential. That being said, it doesn't linearly convert into, the opportunity does not convert directly into women joining the workforce. And the reason I say so, because clearly data shows that in the last many years, while there has been an 8-fold increase in the number of women participating in higher education, actually the participation of women in the workforce has gone down, which is terrible, okay? Right. So obviously a lot of work needs to happen, whether it is through the government or the public sector, the private sector, startups, everybody needs to participate in that.